Hello, I have read the book Dear John, and the main character, Dear John Tree, of Dear John. He was raised in Virginia, North Carolina. He loved growing up in Wilmington as a child. The weather was always nice, and the beach were beautiful. John liked being busy and hated to be alone. When he attended high school, he was a rebellious stage of his life. He looked at school as a more of a social time than a time to learn. His father and him had complicatedly different physically characters. In fact, you might never know they were related. His eyes and his hair were both brown, and his skin was an olive color that by May would entirely turn into a dark tan. After high school, he had a few jobs that he hated and got tired of, so he decided to join the army. Savannah Lynn Curtis is another main character in Dear John. She was from Lenoir, North Carolina. She was raised by a Christian family, and she loved the way that she was raised. She attended church weekly and lived a very Christian life with no shame. She could be physically described as having long brown hair, and she smiled so you could see a slightly gap between her teeth. She liked to participate in Habitats for Humanity and other activities that would help and benefit other people. She attended the University of North Carolina, Capitol Hill, and plans to major in special education. She was inspired to teach special educated by her friend Tim and his autistic daughter brother. Mr. Tree is John Tree's father. Mr. Tree raised John alone without the help from anyone, including John's mother. All through he raised John by himself. He and John were complicatedly different people. Mr. Tree is described as having sandy hair, hazel eyes, and freckles. His personality is so very different from John's. Mr. Tree is passive and often looks inside himself to find the right thing to do. He also prefers to be alone and keep to himself. He worked for the mail service and completed the same routine every day. He would wake up, cook breakfast, which was the same every day: eggs, toast, and bacon. Then he would go to work at 7:35 every morning. He always paid bills at Saturday mornings. He did the laundry every Sunday afternoon. All through, he was set in his ways to being off quiet or and following routine. He raised John well and to the best of his abilities. And he never complained about John and was slow to anger. All through, John did some things that most fathers wouldn't be too proud of. Tim is one of Savannah's good friends from childhood. Tim grew up with his family's house being right next to Savannah's house and farm. he was always being there for Savannah because he liked Savannah. Growing up in Lenoir, North Carolina, Tim had a crush on Savannah, and ever since he was 12, but he was too shy to tell her. Tim eventually get married to Savannah while John is serving in the army. He grew up raising his autistic brother, Alan. So, Tim's parents die in a car accident attended a car accident when Tim is in the 20s. He also is diagnosed with melanoma and will have to get special treatment to survive. A summary of Dear John. Dear John is a book written by Nicholas Sparks. This is the story of a couple who fall madly in love and are separated, yet they never stop loving each other. It's a story of unconditional love and fate. John falls in love one summer with a girl named Savannah in North Carolina. They are madly in love, yet John has to leave town to attend military service. Having dropped out of school, he enlisted in a U.S. Army force, and as a way to find meaning to his life, his father has difficulties carrying a normal conversation with him, and he has an observation with coins collection, and John suspects something is wrong with his father, but refuses to face it, and never go see a doctor with him. John leaves for the military, leaving Savannah behind, but they decide to maintain a long distance relationship. As he loves her more than anything, and it's look forward to see each other. While on leave, they remain in touch and keep sending each other letters to keep each other in his life. John and Savannah decide to stay together and continue to write to each other. Eventually, however, Savannah, being away to college, fall in love with another man, and she sent John a letter telling him that she has stopped waiting for him, as she feels that they are growing apart, and she now wants a real life. And a real relationship. John is heartbroken and they stop exchanging letters. One day, while still being on leave, John learns of his father's death. He comes home and then looks for Savannah, and that is when he sees her with another man, her husband. They talk, and even though she still has feelings for him, and he have for her, she wants to leave their story in the past. John decided to let Savannah go, as he loves her more than anything, and wants her to be happy. The man Savannah married is her childhood best friend, Tim. Tim, who John had become friends with, then dating her this summer they first met. Savannah tells that Tim has melanoma. Milano med, and that he is going to die unless he receive better treatment and another hospital, which she cannot afford. Tim goes to the hospital to speak with Tim. John goes to the hospital to speak with Tim, who tells him that should something happen to him, he wants John to take care of Savannah, despite the prospect of being reunited with the woman of his life. John decides to donate his father's coins collection to Tim's fund to take them to get the treatment. John then goes back to Iraq and never speaks to Savannah again, and continues living his life in the army. The main theme is love. John and Savannah are deeply in love in each other. The whole story is about their love for each other. John and Savannah have a burning passion for each other in the book, even through John went off into the army, he had to balance that out, that his relationship with Savannah. When John met Savannah, he fell in love with her in 2 seconds. John started 2 weeks together. That's all it took, 2 weeks for me to fall in love. That's a quote he said in the book. Every time John sees Savannah, he gets the smile on his face and his heart drops. John also started forwards towards Savannah. And a quote more. Right before everything went black, you wanna know the very last thing that entered my mind. You. That's a quote he said. He said this to her when he was telling the story about his army. Personally, I think the author is trying to tell us that even though John was fighting for the country, the real battle is love, because that is the only thing he wants to fight for. And I want to relate the book to almost all love stories. They all give us the same feeling while reading it. But one I'm thinking about is The Notebook. She does also live a life where she doesn't remember him, but he still loves her no matter what. He would do anything for her and fight every battle to get her. And that's the same like John would fight for Savannah. The reason why I chose this book were that I had seen the movie, but as well I know there is so much more in a book, so I wanted to read the book also because I like the movie. The book is so much more detailed than the movie, and I thought that it was hard to stop reading if you were in the middle of a great scene. Stories like Dear John are beautiful. While reading it, you can't stop thinking about someday. You hope that someday it will be you that have such a wonderful man who would love you so much. The difference between the movie and the book are that the book can get the tears come out, but in the movie the situation are not described so much that you can see yourself in her footsteps. Yeah, and that was it.